So in the last few tutorials, we have seen how we can use a ref object to hold values across the lifecycle of a component. So useRef returns you an object which has a key called current, within which you can put a value and access them across multiple renders. You can modify it, and so basically each time it renders, you can modify the current, the ref object, and it will not trigger a render, but it's good for bookkeeping. But there is an actual another more important use case of useRef, and that is to access the DOM node. So if you want to access the paragraph element here to get the dimensions, the height or width of this paragraph element, refs are very handy. So I'm going to, I created a ref and I gave it as a prop to the paragraph element. And now I'm going to put in two console log statements. So useRef takes an initial value because we didn't give it an initial value. Here it logged undefined. I can give it null. It's not necessary, but to give an initial value, but generally it is initialized with null. And I'm going to put in a use effect to run immediately after mount. And here, if I log ref.current, it should show us the paragraph element. So this is the actual DOM node. This paragraph here is a React element. This is the DOM node that was created as a result of this React element. So now we can grab the dimensions of this element. So I can create a state variable called dimensions using useState and initialize it to null. And on mount, I can set dimension to ref.current. So ref.current is a DOM node, and it has, each DOM node has this member function called get bounding client rect, which gives the dimensions of the DOM node. So now if I put in a console log statement for dimension, we should see an initial null and then this DOM rect here. It has a height property which we can utilize here. So I'm going to say dimensions, if dimensions exist, then create a paragraph element as dimensions dot height, otherwise null. Okay, so this 16 is the height of this paragraph element, and it was calculated using the ref that we created. So refs are very useful when you want to perform operations on DOM elements. If you want to get the dimensions of a DOM element, if you want to resize it or scroll it or perform actions on different events dynamically, refs are very useful. So in the next few tutorials, we'll discuss more about refs and how we can add event listeners to the ref and create more powerful hooks.